I'm Ann Lichtenwald. I'm the director of the Maine Animal Health Lab, and we are a lab here at University of Maine in Orono and do a lot of salmonella testing. We do salmonella testing largely because a number of years ago there was a salmonella outbreak problem, and in about 1988-89 the University of Maine, in collaboration with the state of Maine, decided that we could help with doing surveillance against salmonella on poultry operations. And so they instituted the Salmonella Risk Reduction Program at that time. This program has been, again, in place for some time, and it's been very successful. We've had a lot of people, you know, cooperating with us to make this program work. It's not required of small backyard poultry owners, but in some ways, you know, people may want to have salmonella testing of their backyard flocks, and we're happy to do that. It's not expensive to do, and it will help you know whether you have salmonella in your flock.
What I'm doing here is taking a sample of the chicken serum and depositing it on the plate, and then I've put a positive control, which we have here in-house, and a negative control, so that when I compare the sample to the reactions, I know where my sample stands. So I mix the ANA serum, which has antibodies, with an antigen, and there's a reaction that occurs, and you can see it once we mix the two together. Comes out as an agglutination where you see purple specks, and as you precipitate, really, and as you see, the positive is right here, and you can see that it's clearing out, and we've got a reaction, and the sample also has a reaction. So these birds we're expecting a reaction from, because they're actively vaccinating the birds to protect them against salmonella in the field. So this is good. And you can see that my negative is negative. There is nothing going on with that. So this is a test that's this is exactly what we're looking for. And so this is an ongoing part of the whole program. Birds are protected in the field. They're less likely to pick up salmonella, less likely then to transmit that to the food product. And so it's just an ongoing small part of the whole program.
Sure, the environmental tests are brought in and they are inoculated with a selective media. So that media helps salmonella grow and kind of keep some of the other bacteria that could be in there down so that doesn't grow as much. And then those samples are then streaked onto another selective media in a plate form, where this also helps salmonella grow more than other kinds of bacteria. And from there, any colonies that look salmonella suspicious on these plates are tested a little bit further. They are inoculated onto slants that will give us a salmonella profile. There are certain color reactions that tell us that it could be salmonella. And then that's checked with an antiserum that would tell us whether the colony that we selected was salmonella or not. And we have another antiserum that will tell us if it is a group D salmonella, which salmonella enteritidis is a group D salmonella. So from there, they're sent to be confirmed by the National Veterinary Services Laboratory to confirm that we have found SE in the environmental sample.